Next, talking about good hygiene. We need to minimize the contact with infected persons or things used by them. Always cover your nose or mouth with a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Always wash your hands before eating or touching food. So from food and water, we move on to the next, that is good hygiene. So what do we mean by good hygiene? We need to maintain personal hygiene and we need to minimize the contact with infected person or things used by them. Always cover your nose or mouth with a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Always wash your hands before eating or touching food. The next is, we're going to talk about preventing breeding of mosquitoes and flies. So the next is preventing breeding of mosquitoes and flies. Mosquitoes, as we have already seen, breed in stagnant water. So in order to avoid this, we need to see that water does not remain stagnated in our houses or in our surroundings. So do not allow water to collect in your neighborhood in pots, tires, vessels, ditches, drainages, etc. So the next is, we're going to talk about preventing breeding of mosquitoes and flies, because mosquitoes and flies are the most important carriers of various germs and they are responsible for the spread of many diseases. So how are we going to prevent the breeding of them? This is possible only if we do not allow stagnant water to remain in our houses or surroundings. So mosquitoes breed in stagnant water, and do not allow water to stagnate in our houses or surroundings, that is in pots, tires, ditches, drainages, vessels, etc. So we need to see that water is safe when we consume it. That is, it needs to be boiled, filtered or chlorinated. Food and water should always be kept covered so that flies cannot pollute it. The next point is good hygiene. We need to minimize the contact with the infected person or things used by them. Always cover your nose or mouth with a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Always wash your hands before eating or touching food.